Welcome to my YouTube tutorial. Today I'm going to teach you how to create, compile and run a very simple C++ program without using any integrated development environment like TurboC or CodeBlocks. You just have to have a compiler, C++ compiler installed on your system. So I'm using a Linux machine. Okay, I'll show you. See, this is a Linux 64-bit Fedora OS. Whichever the system you are using doesn't matter. Only thing is the installation of the compiler differs. Rest of the things remains same. So the best compiler for C++ is GNU C++. How to check whether it's installed or not? Type G++ and version. See, in my system it is 8.1.1 is already installed. So in case if you are not installed it, so how to install it? So in Fedora or CentOS or Red Hat, you just have to do sudo dnf install gcc c++. It will ask you for the password, and if it is installed it will just skip and say dependency resolved. If it has not installed, it will start installing. Okay, if you are using Ubuntu, instead of GCC C++, you give G++. Okay, and instead of DNF package manager, Ubuntu or Debian systems have apt-get package manager. Okay, sudo apt-get install G++. This will install the G++ compiler on Ubuntu. And if you are using Windows or Mac OS, I have given the link in my description. Windows use min gw, and if you are using Mac OS, use Xcode. Okay, so I assume that you have the compiler ready with you. So let me create first C++ file. So go to any file system, open one empty folder. Okay, I am using documents. So to show you how to create and compile a C++ program, so first of all change my directory to documents. Okay, now I am inside the document. I will use the touch command to create C++ file. So touch sample.cpp will create C++ file for me. You can see sample.cpp got generated. So now you can edit it and write the content. You can directly right click on C++ and open with any editor, GUI editor, or I'll use vi sample.cpp and I'll enter I, which is for insert, and I'll start typing hash include the header file io stream, which is to input output the information on the console. Okay, using namespace std. I'm using standard namespace. And the method name, that is int main, that means it returns integer. I am going to cout, that is to print out welcome to C++. And I'll give next line slash n, which will print next line and return 0, returns nothing. Okay, when you finish typing, just give escape colon wq. It is saved. If you don't know how to use editing in VI, you can just right click on the file and open in any of your favorite compiler. Editor. So you can see I'm using Genie. The same thing, instead of VI, I can type here also. Okay, let me close it. So now your file is ready. How to compile it? Okay, you just have to do G++ and your file name sample.cpp. It need not be cpp, you can give .c also if you have created sample.c, both will work fine. So when I press enter, it will generate the output file executable. See, a.out is generated. In case if there was any compile time error, it will show it and you have to rectify it. So a.out is generated. How do you run it? You just have to type /a.out. So you can see your output. Welcome to C++. So that's it. Well, if you want your own name instead of a.out, you can let me delete it. If you wanted some other name, how do you generate? -o, that is to generate object file, and give your name, any name. I'll give sample itself. Okay, G++, -o, and some name where the executable will be generated as in this name, and press enter. You can see sample. Same thing, /sample will give you the same output again. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and like the channel. Thank you.